She's not wearing a bra.
Hold on.
For you.
As a reminder, please make sure that all cell phones, pagers, and CB radios are in a silent position. We welcome all of you here today as we have gathered together in the presence of God and these witnesses to join Shawn Alexander and Keri Kennedy in holy matrimony. Marriage is a gift given to us so that we might experience the joys of unconditional love with a lifelong partner. God designed marriage to be an intimate relationship between a man and a woman, mentally, emotionally, physically, and spiritually. And just as the two of you will make vows to each other, God has also made vows to each of us in His Word when He said, I will betroth you to myself forever in lawful wedlock with unfailing devotion and love. I will commit myself to you to have and to hold, and you shall know the Lord. So Shawn and Keri, because your deep love for each other comes from God above, this is a sacred moment, and it is with great reverence that I now ask you to declare your intent. And so Shawn, do you take Keri to be your wedded wife, to live together after God's ordinance in the holy estate of matrimony? There's more. Right? Yeah. That was easy. Do you promise to love her, comfort her, honor and keep her in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others remain faithful to her as long as you both shall live?
I do.
And Keri, do you take Shawn to be your wedded husband, to live together after God's ordinance in the holy estate of matrimony? Do you promise to love him, comfort him, honor and keep him in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others remain faithful to him as long as you both shall live?
I do.
And who gives Keri to be married to Shawn?
Her mother.
Today is the beginning of a new life together for the two of you. It marks the commencement of new relationships for your families, for your friends, and especially for each other. And so you've invited these guests to this special moment as they give recognition to the worth and beauty of your love, and they add their best wishes to the words that will unite you as husband and wife. God knew your needs when he brought you together. He knew exactly what you needed to be complete. And so now he wants you to commit yourselves to each other as the one that he has chosen to complete you. Of course, the secret is love. But what is love? Through the ages, men and women have written countless books and poems and songs trying to describe what love is. But in my experience, I found the best description of love comes from the author of love, from God himself. In his word in 1 Corinthians 13, we call it the love chapter. And it reads simply like this. Love is patient and kind. Love is not jealous or boastful. It is not arrogant or rude. Love does not insist on its own way. It is not irritable or resentful. It does not rejoice at wrong, but rejoices in the right. Love bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never fails. So faith, hope, and love abide these three. The greatest of these is love. And so, Shawn, if you will love Keri as Christ loves the church, and Keri, if you will respond to Shawn as unto the Lord, then your companionship as husband and wife will blossom into a physical, emotional, and spiritual closeness beyond which nothing can compare. As a seal of this covenant, we are going to now exchange rings. The wedding ring serves as a symbol of the promises that you've made to each other. It's an outward and visible sign of an inward and invisible love that binds your hearts together. The wedding ring is also a symbol of what God is. He is eternal. And so as you will see, your rings are also without beginning and without end. And so I believe this exchange of rings not only reminds us of the unending love that you have for each other, but also for the love God has for each of you. May I please have the rings? And Shawn, if you will please repeat after me, sir. This ring I give in token and pledge as a sign of my love and devotion. With this ring, I thee wed. And Keri, if you'll please repeat after me. This ring I give in token and pledge as a sign of my love and devotion. with this ring, I thee will. Go ahead and hold hands. And now if you'll please bow your heads and we'll bless this union. Our Heavenly Father, we ask your blessing upon these two lives and the home they are establishing today. May the love they have for each other grow deeper and stronger because of their love for you. Lord, you guided them to each other. Now guide them in this new journey as husband and wife. As they walk down this path, light their way so they may keep their eyes focused on your will, their hands holding fast to your truth, their feet firmly planted in your word, and their hearts bound together by your love. And we pray this in your name. Amen. Amen. Shawn and Keri, since you have consented together in holy matrimony, and you've pledged yourselves to each other by your vows and by the giving of these rings, and you've declared your commitment of love before God and these witnesses, I now pronounce you husband and wife in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Those that God has joined together, let no man separate them. And now, Shawn, your moment. You may kiss your bride.
Say woo!
Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. and Mrs. Shawn Alexander. Gentlemen, on behalf of the bride and groom, I want to thank you so much for joining us on what's turned into a pretty darn nice evening. You're now invited to step up into the reception area. You get a head start. If the family will please stay, we got to do more pictures. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Here we go.
Same as Casey. First time I met Shawn, he had to endure my PowerPoint, which, as some of you know,
brutal.
Kind of a scary thing. Yes. And the threats of, you ever hurt my baby sister, and you'd be sorry, and still stuck around, so we're thankful for that at this point, but at the time I was like, alright, let's get this kind of off. But, no, I'm so proud of you both, and I cannot ask for a better guy than my sister, truly. Shawn, you bring such an upbeat, positive joy to our family that Keri often needs to bring her up. Truly though, y'all complement each other so well. Keri, you're so strong, and you're also both. I'm so proud of you, and I could not ask for that person for you, and I'm so thankful that y'all found each other. I wish you the years of happiness. I love you guys so much. Cheers.
I met Keri. She's a precious little sister to me.
I have my own sister.
She's great, she's beautiful, she's fine, and there's nobody else besides Shawn that can treat me like her. The first time I met Shawn, threw her a treats her with respect, and I think we can all learn from the kind of relationship they have with each other. It's precious. And we can say this for all time.
Simply agreed, disagreed that he and Andrew can see eye to eye on Congress and me. I think in the big scheme of things, that's probably a small issue to have. But in all honesty, I feel very fortunate to be Shawn. He's fine on me. One of the things that struck me about him, probably about this time,